honestly, I feel like, you know, we might be able to break it again as far as the way we play together, the way we move the ball. Everybody's, you know, playing for each other. And then our defense creates offense. So, and then Tibbs wants us to shoot more threes. So we might be able to beat it again. So.
It seemed like you guys, just from watching on the bench, like you guys were up and celebrating every time you got a good look. Like, is that sort of contagious when you start taking that many?
Yeah, I mean, I think our culture is just kind of really together as far as, you know, everybody cheering for each other. When somebody has success, we all have success. So, you know, that's kind of our culture. When somebody does good, we feel like we all do good.
It looked like he hit like a three in a row. I think Julius hit one. He looked like he's laughing coming down court, like almost like couldn't believe how it's raining in.
Which one?
I think when Julius hit the one right after you did.
Yeah, he banged it in.
Yeah.
He said, we'll take it.
What was the eye thing?
I lost my contact. So I was acting like I couldn't see.
You caught it though on the floor.
I caught it.
That,
yeah.
If you guys missed that, he literally popped the contact in the air.
Put it back in 10 seconds. It's like a quick pitch stop. Just
it was awesome.
Wait, so what happened? Something, your contact popped out. You caught it and just put it right back in your eye.
Yeah.
And then you celebrated like I'm blind.
Yeah.
I got the whole thing now.
How fun was this night with all the Knicks fans in this building?
It was great. You know, it kind of reminds me of college playing in Kentucky, where our fans travel. The Knicks fans, best fans in the league. So, you know, it's great to have your home court advantage. And I feel like, you know, on the road, we got a little bit of advantage too, just knowing we have a great support system. So it's great.
When you guys see the way this starting unit got you guys off today, and then I think you, Alec, really kind of pulled it away in the fourth quarter, is it just kind of, you guys have so many weapons right now?
Yeah, I think, you know, that's a big part of our team's success is our depth. You know, we can go full 15. You know, everybody does something really special on our team, and everybody knows what they're good at. And we play to each other's strengths, and we cover each other's weaknesses. So that's what makes this team really special.
What's this like for you? In the first game, you didn't get many minutes. This game, you get do you expect this kind of thing to happen all season, or how are you approaching it?
I mean, I don't know, but I expect to stay ready. You know, right after that Celtics game, I went straight to the gym, so. You know, I expect to stay ready throughout the season, whether my name's called, whether it's not called. That's something that I've learned from a lot of players, you know, before I came into the league, is always stay ready, always be, you know, wait for your opportunity. And when you get your opportunity, go in and play hard and have fun. So I think that's one of the biggest things that I've learned since coming into the league.
Did any of the coaches explain why you didn't get a double overtime game and there weren't a lot of minutes?
Not really. And, I mean, I didn't play as good in the first half. So, you know, there's nothing that you can really do except, like I said, staying ready. You know, when your name is called, just be ready to go.
Well, you said you can be 24 three-pointers. How high do you think this team can go?
I don't know. Like, we'll see. I think we're in for a real fun season. Everybody's working hard each and every day to get better. So.
You're really good friends with Obi, and just to hear the chance starting early this season, Obi, I mean, do you feel really good for your buddy?
Absolutely. When Obi's playing good, I feel like I'm playing great. Like, when he went between the legs, I thought I went between the legs. So that's my dog. So, you know, whenever he's playing good, I feel really good.
Is that minutes thing sort of what you were saying about you guys have 1 through 15 that, you know, one night it could be Kem is playing 30 minutes or?
It could be anybody. You know, that's what makes our team special, and that's why we're bought in. To everybody, you know, when somebody has success, it's everybody's success. So that's what makes this team special, like I keep saying.
Man, you're always making improvements in your game constantly. So going into this season, what are some things that you're looking to improve upon or get people to notice, hey, I work on this?
I try to get a lot stronger in the off season. I just got done lifting just now. Just trying to improve every facet of my game, just watching film, trying to get better, whether I'm on the ball, off the ball, just being able to make reads and play in multiple positions, and then defense, you know, that'll always get you on the coach too, so just trying to improve that as well.
Have you ever seen the play where Ron Baker picks his contact off the floor and puts it back in his eye in the middle of the game?
Oh, no, if it would have landed on the floor, I got it.
middle of the game.
All right.
Picked it up.
Next quick.